One more try. Much better. Much better start. split on John Gutter. Better than my personal best so far, but of course it's only two stages in. Thank you. Oh crap. I was not paying attention in that moment. I was trying to find out how to ban a bot from my Twitch chat. Oops. Oh, dang it. I blame the Twitch bot. It's fine, it's fine. Dang it. There are too many projectiles at once for that one. Oh crap. This Peppermint's been kind of a bad Peppermint, but hopefully it's at least gonna be acceptable. Okay, not bad. Can't skip this, so I will spend this time. Yeah, that Peppermint was not one of my better ones, but I mean, it's all good. I can still make the sub 2.5. Are you kidding? He wasn't even like trying. Whatever. He wasn't even facing my direction. Whatever. Okay. There we go. Now this is essential to the speedrun. You gotta look cool. There we go. Bloodstained with the newest update. Just like how I'll be getting the Mort Cube later in this run, changing your outfit is imperative in a speedrun. You have to do it. If you don't, I mean, what? You unlocked the cool thing. You gotta use it. It's unoptimal if you don't. Duh. Oh, crap. There we go. And now, the very worst secret room. Okay, made it out without getting damaged. That's better than I could say for some of my attempts. Most of my attempts, actually. hate that one. I don't yet know how to run through it quickly without getting damaged and, you know, essentially ending up being slower overall. I do wonder if just sort of walking through that one is optimal, or if there is, like, some sort of speed trick that I just don't have yet, you know? Is there something I'm missing? Or is that one really that much of a pain? Oh, crap. How did I get hit by both of those things, man? Ugh. The second lap through Blood Sauce wasn't very good, but hopefully I can make up for the damage I took. That was very, very close. Okay, there's the S. Good. I didn't lose out on that by getting hit a few times. Just gotta remind myself. Okay, but for real, just gotta remind yourself, even some of the world records have had mistakes before in many a game. Split? Green split overall, but it is not gold, unfortunately. Oh, welcome to the chat. And yeah. I mean, so long as it's not a mistake, like one that makes me have to redo the entire stage, and it's just something that's like a bit of a few second annoyance, it's bound to happen. I think in this current PB I have that I didn't record, I think I had to redo an entire stage because I messed something up. So hopefully that doesn't happen again. You know, back when I first started speedrunning this, I didn't even necessarily really want to go too hard on it. I was just like, okay, I just want to get like sub 3 hours. And then the sub 3 hour run I got, or the last run I did on stream was like over 3 hours because of several big mistakes, and I was really annoyed by that. But then, like, off stream, I got it in like I beat it in like 2 hours 34, and then recently I beat it in 2 hours and 30. So I think my goal has switched just to below 2.5 hours, just because I think as so long as I don't make any of like the big mistakes that I have in some of my previous runs, I can do it, I think. I'm never gonna be oh my gosh. That is unfortunately a big problem. Wow. When was the last time that happened to me? Ugh. Well, this is probably gonna be a red split on oregano, unfortunately. Or maybe I still have enough time saved from earlier to be positive in time, but that was unfortunately that did cost me quite a bit of time. Oh my gosh. Ah! Come on, bro. Respawn. Thank you. Okay, I should still be in a positive state after this oregano. It's not a pretty run of this stage, but I mean, at least I'm pretty sure. What? Normally I'd have an S rank by now. Where's my S rank? There it is. Okay, that was very close. But that works. That is a green split. Still got some time saved over my PB. That was close. I would have lost a little bit more time, a few more seconds there. Ah, dang it. My combo. That turkey gave me a lot of trouble this run. Wow. Oh well. I should still be able to get an S rank. Are you kidding me? I've never let that happen in a speedrun before. That's so much time loss. Why did he not have the speed to go through the box? What the heck? What? The ghost power-up is so annoying. Embarrassing mistake, in all honesty. Does that say I'm down a second now? Ugh. Another mess up in World 2 that cost me 18 seconds. Ugh. That's... Come on. I love the when the potatoes in particular get really shocked. It reminds me of that that comic of Steve Harvey. Meat and huh? Okay. Gold split on Fun Farm. So, going into Fast Food Saloon with some good time. Dang. Okay, that was sort of a flub there, but it's whatever, it's whatever. I've still got time saved. Are you kidding me? Not my fastest vigilante. Okay, I can't get hit anymore. Otherwise, I gotta restart the whole fight. There it is. The entire fight needs to be restarted, of course. Ugh. Ugh. My timing has gone all out of whack. Officially in the freaking red. Ugh. That is a shame and a big annoyance. Plus 45 seconds. Ugh. Oh, speedruns use the in-game timer now. I'm gonna be honest, I don't really pay attention to, like, the speedrunning community. I just, like, you know, on a whim, I was just like, I really like this game. I want to try playing, I want to try a speedrun. And so I didn't really, I honestly did not know about some of the updates that had been happening. So, that's helpful. Oh, come on. That's... Oh, right. The in-game timer stops during the P rank animation. So, like, that whole skip isn't even, like, when it comes to the bosses, that's... Okay. Huh. Oh, come on. I was hoping I was going fast enough that that wouldn't matter. Or that, you know, that I would be able to do the dive, but... It doesn't work that way. Oh crap, why did I dive there? I'm still going to, like, do my, you know, do my splits and stuff just because, you know, just for my own sort of keeping track of things. Wow, I'm kind of surprised I managed to thread the needle and get hit by that. That's impressive in a depressing sort of way. Depressive, I guess? I have a very love-hate relationship towards this stage, because it does introduce us to Gustavo and Brick, but at the same time it also introduces us to these pickle enemies, and I hate the pickle enemies so much. They are so annoying. The pickles and the... the pickles and the fake cardboard pizza cutouts, those are probably like the two most annoying units in the game, in my opinion. Yeah, those ones can be the spitting cheese slimes. In particular, I think about that one that's on Crust Cove right after you, you ride the water. Sometimes, like, depending on how fast you go or something, like, it shoots one sometimes and it shoots two another time, and like, it feels really like. I don't know, it feels weird to react to sometimes, because sometimes you have to wait for the second projectile, sometimes you can just, you know, sometimes he doesn't get the chance to shoot one, and not to mention just, yeah, it can be an annoying enemy for sure. I am so happy that they updated this this portion. It was honestly a little bit infuriating to get the P rank on this stage, just because of that that huge area with the incredible like lack of any point gain, where like one mistake causes you to drop the entire combo. So I'm glad that they added those little I guess I'd call them like Tinkerbell bricks, Tinker bricks, to keep your points up during that whole. There we go. There were a couple days when I was like, when I was grinding this game out, and I was getting like, consistently, I was getting like 98% in my, you know, final scores, and I was just like, so confused as to why I wasn't, you know, getting the full 100. I just kept forgetting that like third secret in Gnome Forest. Oh my gosh. For some reason I had it in my... Okay. Oh my god. Are you kidding me? I have to redo the noise fight too? Ugh. Hello. Welcome to the chat. Okay, now that I'm doing better, I can actually say I could have sworn that there was like that when the noise did the skateboard, the first time he did it, he only like skated on the ground. For some reason I had it in my brain, like I thought for sure there was a version of that where like he doesn't do any jump, and then when he does it for the second time, that's when he starts doing his jump, you know? Because, like, each time he does his abilities, they have, like, you know, he tricks you the second time that he does his thing. And I, for some reason, I had it in my brain, like, oh, that's what happens with this, with the skateboard. But I guess I was just mistaken. Ah, my time, she is in the red. And it's not gonna be pretty. But, I mean, as you can see from my upcoming golf, it goes from a minute 5 to a minute 18, so like, obviously, in my personal best, I had to redo that entire stage. And so, hopefully, I don't have to do that this time, and that'll be a significant time save compared to my personal best. Unfortunately, I did lose a minute and a half in noise. Ah, dang it. Whatever, you can't get an S rank without eating a few hot dogs, I guess. Ah. Ah! I hate golf! Yeah, I like to feel like for a lot of the parts of golf, I can be pretty consistent, you know? But like, sometimes, when like one bad thing happens in the golf stage, you have to like, go back and, you know, and get the little cheese ball and It becomes a whole thing that totally changes up the rhythm of your gameplay. I definitely think that the gimmick is very fun, but it can lead to some problems in a run. Or at least some like It throws you off your... It throws me off my mojo sometimes. But, I mean... Hey, I'm still... I've still on a P rank. So, I mean... Can't be doing too bad this run. Much better than my last time, that's for sure. Dang it, I did not want to. Didn't exactly want to be a ball, I could be going fast. Whatever, it's whatever. All right. I don't know what it is about Deep Dish 9 in particular, but this one also is like very, very particular with a P rank. It feels very hard for me to justify skipping too much in this stage for the sake of speed, just because every time I've gotten a P rank on this, or like every time during a speed run I've gotten a P rank on this stage, I've either had to redo the stage or like it's been very close, you know? Ah. Like, you could skip all of those little, like, all of those during that secret room, but, like, I'm afraid to, you know? Like, is that gonna break the run later, you know? Where I'm gonna have to redo the stage? Though I do have to say, it's probably, like, in terms of aesthetics and style, one of my favorite stages. I love the soundtrack, the variation in the different, like, you know, parts of the level. It feels very, very unique. I think the only one that I really would say I, like... This one and Fast Food Saloon in particular are two of my favorites. I just love Fast Food Saloon's soundtrack. Oh wow, I cannot believe I weaved between all those portals. All right. Hey, I P-ranked all these ones. Dang it. Thank you. Now, I know that there's this, that whole area where you unlock, or where you get, janitor. You can skip the whole thing about them stealing, brick away by doing a super taunt, but I honestly don't know if it saves any time, but I don't know. I just think it's neat. Oh, crap. That's definitely not going to save any time. Okay. Give me some... There we go. Keep my combo. They do. Huh. Dang it. Make sure not to hit Snotty. Into Peppy Pot. Ah, dang it. That was close on it. If I had done that like a little bit sooner, this would have had to be an entire redo of Pepivod from the I was so close to missing that topping. Ugh. Dang it. No. How did I? Ah, there goes my pee. So wait, now that the speedrun timer goes off of in-game time instead of a timer, Any result screen? I'm gonna have to look into that. I'm going to continue to do the pause thing just because, you know, it's after all the times I've spent training, you know, it feels like, you know, that's sort of how I'm supposed to do it. It's muscle memory. Oh hey, I got a pumpkin. Thank you. Ah, oh, crap. Oh well, it was just a few seconds. Make sure not to step on Snotty. Very important. Very important. Just like changing your skin or getting the Mort Cube, you have to avoid Snotty. The little snowman units are so unforgiving. If you're not going at like maximum speed, they will harm you. Oh, come on! I've avoided that so many times during my practice runs. Ah. Oh well. That was the most annoying place for a present to be dropped. Wait. Did I get the achievement for all SRP ranks in the area? Am I missing one? I'm not missing one, right? Oh, right, I could have gone into the corner for this one, too. But, even outside of the corner, it's not necessarily hard to dodge. At least I didn't have to redo him like I did the vigilante and the noise. Okay, PS, PS, PSS, okay. So I didn't miss anything during that. Right? Yeah, no, I didn't miss anything, okay. I was just... I guess I just didn't see the achievement come up, and so I was just like... Or the task. I was just... a little bit worried. Wow, that's the first time I've gotten caught by that. during my practice runs, I can usually see McPig over there. I believe that is... McPig is the one who appears, and then, like... You know, he'll appear and then, like, vanish away, depending on if you get far enough in a stage in a specific amount of time. I'm so glad that they also, they changed the lap too, so that, Brick destroys the pizza time segment, slash lap two. They removed the, that annoying, ramp. I could not think of the word for a second there. Ah, man. Well, it doesn't... What? the in-game timer is what the final thing is, so maybe this won't even affect that. It's whatever. And split. Now, don't make a sound also feels very tight in its execution of getting a P rank. It feels like it can be a little bit annoying sometimes. But overall, the stage is very, very funny. And I forgive it. How did I fall so fast after that air spin? Normally I prefer to do a butt slam on that, but it's whatever. You gotta learn to improvise. Oh, dang it. Dang it. The gun upgrade is very fun, funny, and cathartic on the stages that have it, but it does sort of hamper your movement. Like, you can't, like, I can't do the, like, the crouch dash, I can't do the, you know, I can't even do an air grab. Or I can't even do a grab in general, so, like, there are some techniques that are just, like, locked away behind the gun. Dang it. Destroy that? That can't. Yeah, let's go. On to war. Crap. Ugh, I hate the tank missiles. You can't can't even parry him properly. I never expect something that I parried to hit me again, you know? I really hope that that doesn't mess with my P rank overall, or my S rank overall. Those last two. There we go. Okay, cool, still getting an P rank on this one. This might be the run. Oh, I saw my rank change, and for a second I was just like, oh my god, did it go down to an A? Did that one hit make all the difference? But okay, I'm still at an S, that's still fine. Now, 15 minutes. 15 minutes to beat Pizza Head and, or Pizza Face, and get through the Crumbling Tower. And if I can do that, then I will have made my goal. I think they made this less consistent with the update. Maybe not. Maybe they did, but it's whatever. This fight doesn't have a rank. I don't need to reset for it. Okay, down goes phase two. Ugh, 12, is that 12 minutes left? We'll see. I guess more like 14 on the end game. He didn't do it that time. He didn't do the jump. Thank you. Alright. And split on Pizza Head, Pizza Face, Pizza Boy. Whatever, I can still get an S rank. Doesn't need to be a P, it can be an S. Ugh, it's usually around that point when I have a P rank, what the hell? I didn't make it! There it is! Oh, there it is! Oh my god. Holy shit. Holy shit, that was just barely. Oh my god. Oh my god. I did it. I got a sub 2.5. That's 236 or 226.35 on the split. And I believe that said 224 something in the in-game timer. Okay. I'm gonna keep the stream running just until I see the results. But I think that's it. That should be it. That should be a 100% because I got an S rank on the Crumbling Tower. So that should be my goal. That should have been it. Come on, please do not tell me I misjudged something. Yes! Yes! Holy shit! A sub 2.5 hour. I know that's not number one on the leaderboard, but hey. I'd say it's nothing to sneeze at, personally. And with that, well, those of you who came in to watch, thank you for watching. I'll see y'all around. I don't think I'm gonna be speedrunning Pizza Tower anymore, if I'm gonna be totally honest. I reached this goal, and I can't really afford to spend much more time grinding out a game and speedrunning, so I think this is where I'm gonna stand. And with that, see you all around.